Hello everyone, today I'm breaking down the criteria I'm using to pick and shortlist organizations for Google Summer of Code 2024. You've probably heard from various dev influencers that January is the key time for students to contribute. So, I'm laying out the steps I've cooked up to find the right organization, all from digging into some solid GSoC resources. Let's jump into it. A quick disclaimer, I'm no GSoC expert and in fact, I will be applying for the very first time. I'm just documenting my prep journey and putting it out on the internet. Take everything I say with a grain of salt as all of this is just trial and error. So let's get into how I'm choosing. First, go to gsoc-organizations.dev and filter out the first time organizations. Also check the ones that came for the first time in 2022 and returned for the 23 season. These type of orgs might be less crowded, but hey, I won't ignore the seasoned ones if they are beginner friendly. Now with my search narrowed down, I'll peek into each organization and check the technologies they use, picking what I'm comfortable with. I also have to look into past projects, number of slots, and most importantly, navigate the code base by reviewing the issues and merged PRs. Also, checking if the organization is active or not while keeping a close eye on the competition, as I don't want to join a bandwagon of contributors. Repeating this process for all shortlisted organizations, I'll jot down my impressions. I know it takes time, but I hope it's worth it. Almost there, take a breather. Now I'll carefully pick any two orgs that are both easy and interesting to me from the list. Moving on to setting up the projects locally. But since this video is all about selecting the organizations, let's stick to that. I'll share my next steps soon. And hey, I have to join the communication channels of the selected organizations as this will ensure that I'm directly connected to the potential mentors. So, the TLDR of this video is, number 1, go for newer orgs. Number 2, choose an org that's not overcrowded and does not have contributors smarter than you. Number 3, ensure the org is active, review the merged PRs and join the communication channels. Remember, this is just my approach, so feel free to tweak it as per your choices. Also, do share your thoughts in the comments, and if you have any questions related to this, then you can ask them in our Discord server. That's all for this video, thanks for your time.